Hello guys, welcome to BuddyDevelopers once again. So this is one of my localhost website where I'm giving you guys demo of GeoDirectory. So if I go here in my business page, this is how the normal layout of a business archive page in my site. And if I click on this particular post, this is a normal layout of a detail page, which is okay, but not very attractive, I can say. So in this video, we will see how you can make your site attractive with Elementor page builder. So if you guys are not aware of what is Elementor, it's a plugin in WordPress using which you can create attractive website web pages with just few clicks here and there and few drag and drop, and website or web page is ready for you. It have a free version on wordpress.org, but for GeoDirectory, you need Elementor Pro. You can find link of Elementor Pro in the description of this video, which is an affiliated link. So if you click on this link and go to Elementor and buy something, it will help me too. So let's start with this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon. So here you can see that I have Elementor and Elementor Pro plugin active on my site. And you already know that in GeoDirectory, if you go to settings, pages, here you have all the templates of GeoDirectory. So what I'm going to do here is I will create a detail page template, an archive and archive item page template using Elementor. So for that, one way is you can click on this edit with Elementor icon and you can build a page layout like you have built it in Gutenberg. You can similarly build it using Elementor. The other way which I will recommend is go here in this Elementor, here in this template section, and then in the theme builder, and then here you have the section called GD single. So as I've already told, if for GeoDirectory compatibility you need Elementor Pro, so you can find the link in the description and click on that link and buy Elementor Pro if you don't have it. Okay, so for setting the single page layout, that means a single page of my business, what I have to do is I will have to go here in the GD single and just click on add new. So here in the block section, GeoDirectory already provided a default template. You can either use this or you can create your own. So for now, I'm just using it and I will edit it. It wants me to connect the site. Okay, so now I'm connected. So guys, here you can see the page layout has been loaded and now you can make any changes if you want to make. And if you click on this icon here, here you can see all the blocks of Elementor, predefined blocks. You can use any one of them. And also if you go here in the WordPress section at the end, here you will find all the GeoDirectory blocks again, so you can use them too. So by default, in the default page template of GeoDirectory, all the things has been already ready. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna use it without any edit for now, and let's publish it. And now you will move to this screen where you have to add condition. And as you can see, the condition has been added to all GD single page. But if you have any specific condition, like this particular design will be only for a specific CPT, like this business CPT, I don't need it on this age or anything like that, then you can choose the option here, the CPT here. For now, I will just go for add this layout to all the GeoDirectory pages. Let's save it. And after that, let's publish it. Okay. Here is my existing layout, just keeping it here. And when I will go here and I will refresh it on the next step. So guys, here you can see the new layout of my site is here. And you can see the all the pages, that is all the data that is there in my business is appearing here. And it is not only for this business. If you go here in the archive page and click on any business, so basically you can see the layout has been changed. Previously the layout was a basic one, so So guys, this is the magic of Elementor. Now let's change the archive page layout of our site. So for that, I will again go here in the Elementor template and then in the theme builder. And here basically we earlier we have created this GD single. Now we will create GD archive page template. For that, I will click on this add new. So as you can see guys, here is already a page template has been added. So guys, either you can use this template or you can create your own from scratch, because it have everything. So I will just insert it. So there we go. You can see my template has been updated. And if you click on any of this individual item here on the left hand side guys, you will notice that it is nothing but a GD block or GD shortcode. So here you can see it's a GD map shortcode, and everything that you see in GD blocks you have here. So this is the advantage. And if you click on here, you'll see it's a GD loop shortcode, and similarly you have this in form of GD action. And if you click on this guys, you will notice it is nothing but an archive post block, which is not a geodirectory block. Usually, you know, in archive page we use GD loop shortcode or GD loop block of geodirectory, but here in this archive page template which we have created using Elementor, we are using this archive post block, and it is nothing but an Elementor block. Here you can see it is a Elementor block that you can use to show an archive listing. And just to make you guys familiar with the WordPress terminology, so generally, you know, suppose this is my business page where you can see all the businesses are listed with some short information. So we call it archive page where all the listings appear. And if you click on any individual listing here or in any individual business, here the business detail is appearing. So we call it business detail page, or maybe detail page or single page. If you go back in our archive page, these individual grid of businesses, we call them archive item. Okay, so here you will see this archive post. This widget will show you all the archive listing. So it's an Elementor Pro block guys, so you can only use it if you have Elementor Pro license and plugin active on your site. Let's save it and add our condition. So as you can see here, the condition is applied for all the GD archives, but you have an option here to segregate it based on your need. So for example, if I only want this particular archive template to apply on my archive business archive, then I can set it for business archive. Or maybe if I want my events to show a different archive page, then you know, similarly I can define the condition. So for now I just want to use it on my own archive pages. I just want a common template. Okay, now it's done guys. Here is my previous archive page, and I will refresh it. There we go. You can see the difference here. My map is on the left hand side, and the template looks you know, cooler than previous. Okay, now everything is good. Now guys, the time is to update this archive item template. For that, again I will go here in my admin panel, and I will click on this template theme builder. And there I have the tab for archive item. I will click on plus icon here. So here you can see guys, I have three predefined templates. So you can use any one of them. I like this one, so I will use it. There we go guys, my archive page, archive item page has been added. So now it's time to publish it. I will publish it. There is an option to add condition, but you can see if you can read this, you will you know, get the idea. No condition needed. Template used by Elementor post and archive widget skin condition. So we cannot add any condition for this particular template here. I will show you where you can edit this. So let's save it. So guys, now I will refresh my archive page just to see the difference. But here you will notice there is no difference. Okay, so why? Because one more step is needed for this. So let's click on this edit with Elementor Or if you don't see this, this bar, maybe it could be possible you are using some theme or plugin that hiding this in front end. So in that case, you can again go to the admin panel and then theme builder, and then from there you can edit this. But for now, I will just click on this edit with Elementor, and I will click on edit archive because I want to edit the archive page. Okay, so as I already explained, we are using here the archive post block of Elementor. There is an option here, you can see skin, so which is primarily which is set as classic. So there is an option here, you can guys GD archive item, we want to make it GD archive item, and here we can select our template which we have created for archive item. So once we selected this template, you can see the difference guys here in the right hand side. My template is getting applied here, so let's update it and see how our archive page looks like now. So see the difference guys, how cool this template is looking now, and if everything that is here is perfect, and within few clicks we have done it within few clicks, and with some drag and drop here and there. So that's the magic of Elementor guys, and as I already told you that this layout is only possible with Elementor Pro. So you can go in the description and click on the link of Elementor Pro and buy it and enjoy the journey of this beautiful website creation. So soon we will come up with several other builders, like the DB builder, how you can customize your template using DB builder, Beaver builder, and Gutenberg editor. So we will see it in future videos. If you like these videos guys, please don't forget to hit the like button, and you can appreciate and send your queries to me in the comment section. I reply to all of them. And also guys, if you like our work and you want to support us in this venture of simplifying these plugins in these WordPress things for you, you can just go to our site called buddydevelopers.com and click on this support us tab. Thank you so much for watching guys, have a good day.